semester, second year students.
Syllabus.
So, building materials, what are the building materials? Yeah, bricks, concrete, sorry, bricks, cement, okay, walls, beams, all materials. And constructions, different construction types, planning, building planning and building bylaws. Next, first one is the bricks. Today we discussed about bricks and brick masonry. See here, brick and brick masonry. So bricks from last centuries onwards till now we are using the bricks for construction of the building. There are different types of bricks available nowadays. Okay, the most prominent and very available with less cost. Okay, that is clash brick. Why it is more prominent? Because of in thermal power they releases the fly ash. So we that waste material here they convert into bricks, fly ash bricks. At same time some admixtures they are adding, so they can we can get the good quality of ash bricks. This is the happening. Okay. At same time there are few different bricks also nowadays using. At same time those are clay bricks, plastic bricks, some of the transparent bricks also. That depends on the availability and depends on the requirement they are using. At same time, till now there are number of researchers also, they are doing research on this by adding and mixing of or removing and replacing of the ingredients. So now we are discussing about the ingredients of brick. What are the ingredients? That is main important. So first one is the lime, sorry, alumina. The percentage of alumina is 20 to 30%. Okay, in weight of the brick, weight of brick, alumina percentage is 20 to 30. What is the use of this and what is the major role in brick? It plays as a plasticity. So it's act like a plasticity while you are breaking. Okay, so at certain period it make it leaves. Okay, again they getting reposition for that. Okay. At same time, if it is excess, what will happen? If it is excess, so it gets shrinkage. At same time, cracks. Okay, this is the role of aluminum. This is the one of the ingredient in brick. Next one is silica. The percentage of silica is very high. Okay, so at same time, it plays a major role also. Without silica, we can't get the brick. The percentage of silica is 50 to 60%. At the weight of the brick. So, 50 to 60%. What is the main duty of silica? It prevents the shrinkage. See here, it prevents the shrinkage. How it's prevent? Because of the size of the silica, okay, it gives some bonding nature. That bonding, okay, it makes it strong. So that bonding purpose is it's having the perfect agglomeration. So when it's bonding, okay, making our materials, then it reduces the loss of strength, okay, at same time it gives the more strength, so at same time it prevents the shrinkage. What will happen if it is excess? Generally what will happen? If it is more silica, it's converted into dilute nature, no? It's a loss of, okay, and destroy inflammation. Destroy the question. This is okay. So second and third one is lime. The percentage of lime is very normal. Okay. So not much than okay. Silica and aluminum. This is 3 to 5 only. Okay. So here the lime percentage is 3 to 5 of the weight of the brick. So what is the duty of this? So it creates the bonding, okay, it prevents the shrinkages, just like the silica. So lime, there is one property is that if you add the water, okay, it converts into very fine material, okay, thin lamina, okay, it's entered into the very deep porous medium, and it fills the all gaps. That's the general nature. Okay, natural duty of this lime. Okay, so at time if it is excess, what will happen? It gets rust. So we have to be careful, okay, while adding the percentage of lime. And fourth one is iron oxide. Iron, there are different types of iron materials is there. So hematite, magnetite, siderite, limonite, pyrite. Okay, there are different types of iron materials is there. So in this iron material, so percentage of while adding this 5 to 6% is more than this iron. Okay, so this iron gives the color of tubic color. So if it is excess, what will happen? If it is excess, it decolors the brick. That is it. Next one is magnesium. Percentage of the magnesia is very small amount, okay, even though we have to add this one. Okay, so how we can recognize this one in brick? So it shows the alloy change appearance only. These are the ingredients of brick. Next one is harmful ingredients in brick. So why we study these ingredients? I have to be careful to observe because of all materials, all many materials, they maintain certain components. Okay, those components nothing but ingredients. So we should know about the percentage of the ingredients. If it is excess, we lost the production. So we lost more. Next one is the harmful. Harmful ingredients. So harmful ingredients, the first one is lime. Lime is one of the ingredients. Same thing, if it is excess, it changes the volume. we have to find out the material where is available of clay. So that material, what we have to do, we have to do the digging process. After digging, there are different types of all materials, all weathered materials, organic materials, ash, everything, okay, present. Because of that is weathering on clay, okay. So we have to recognize which organic materials, and we have to remove and clean them, okay. So we have to separate from the clay. Otherwise, if it is present in all organic material in a clay, so after burning, okay, after burning, these entire materials, what are the organic materials is there, they are burned and escape and convert into gases, okay. So once it's escape from the brick, okay, it shows the halogenation, okay, vesicular structure. So that type is present in brick, we lost the strength of the brick, that is the happen. So we have to know about the, okay, this is, it is one of the harmful ingredient. So organic material, so it shows the acid. Okay, pores. It appears no pores. Okay, all mention. That is it. Next one is iron. In iron, there are different types of iron or metals is there. In that, the pyrite is very dangerous. Why it is dangerous? No? Once it's getting burned, okay, iron material, this pyrite acts like a crystallization. Slowly to it convert and other materials and given the some strength and does convert into recrystallize. Once it's recrystallized, we can't get the quality of the brick. Okay? So that is the reason. So in iron, depending iron ore materials, it doesn't create that much problem, but this pyrite creates the biggest problem. It gives a headache to us. So that is important. And fourth one is the stone and metals. Here, stone and pebbles. If you are not properly seeing the clay material, okay, if there is remains of some material, okay, some size of material passes through the sieve, okay, it settles in the passes material, okay, in that particular stage, we lost the strength of the brick because it carries the more heavy materials. If it carries more, okay, so if you apply the pressure, okay, compressive pressure on the brick, okay, what has happened? It loses strength, okay. So in particular, what are the stone or pebbles is there? In those areas, they lost strength. They can't give the perfect banding, okay, on the matter materials. That is the problem. Last one is alkaline. Alkalinity shows the fluorescence, okay. So fluorescence, because of while we making a brick, we have to add some water, okay. So that water, okay, it should be pH normal, okay, somewhat acidity as well, okay, not a problem. If it is alkalinity, more alkalinity, so entire brick gets converted into blue. So these are the harmful ingredients. Today's session we covered the ingredients and harmful ingredients. Thank you for listening. Any video.